All right, I'm here with Angel Parker from the show Lab Rats.
That's me.
Okay, so I'm asking a lot of people about their kind of tech lives. Like, are you a music person, a TV person? What do you do to, like, zone out after a long day at work?
I'm definitely a TV person. And I think we're in the golden age of TV, right? TV is so good right now. I'm not quite a music person. My son sort of teaches me how to download songs and what to do. But now that there's Pandora, I'm in heaven because I can just put it on Miles Davis or something.
Right. So Miles Davis. I was wondering. So when you're on Pandora, you basically create a channel. So you have a Miles Davis.
Yes, I've got a Gwen Stefani, and Lil Sublime, of course Beyonce or Jay-Z, just for those days. But it lives on Gwen Stefani, honestly.
Okay.
Yeah, because then you get a little Pink in there, you get a little Sublime in there, you get a little Beyonce.
Do you have a secret guilty pleasure music that maybe you?
I'm an actor, so, you know, show tunes and stuff. Okay.
That's good. That's good.
I have the new CD for Kinky Boots right now.
Which is on fire. Kinky Boots is on fire.
My buddy Stark Sands is one of the leads in it, so that's my new guilty pleasure.
So you're a TV gal, though. Are you watching it live? Are you doing DVR? Are you downloading?
Well, Game of Thrones does not sit on the DVR. That I pretty much watch live. I think I watch the East Coast feed on that one. And then Mad Men and, you know, there's just so much good TV right now. But then I'm sitting there watching Disney, too, because I've got a 7-year-old, let alone I'm on the network. But
right. Tell us about Lab Rats.
Lab Rats is so fun. We're going to start our third season. Oh my gosh, we're so gifted. We're so blessed. Third season in September, and we just have a ball over there. We have so much fun. I get a lot of stuff happening to me because you're the mom. You know, one of the episodes, I've been getting ketchup and mustard on my face. I've been frozen twice.
You've been frozen twice, not once?
Twice. I've been frozen twice.
Now tell me this. You have lots of fans of different ages then.
Yes, yes.
So how do you kind of manage kind of being the grown-up that you are, but also having this childlike following out there?
I love it. I really love it. Kids are the best fans. They really are. They don't quite know what to say, but they are, you know, you're Angelina Jolie to them. They just love it. They quote your lines. They know the jokes better than you know the jokes. And they love it so much, and it's so pure. So I love when I see kids sort of peek out from around their mom and their eyes go wide because I go up to them and I'm like, do you watch Lab Rats? And then I'm like, I'm on that show. And they're like, I know.
That's so fantastic.
Yes. Yeah,
so let me ask you. No,
just the conversation starts there. So
tell me this. Have you ever had an interaction offset, off of the kind of the filming location? Have you ever had a moment where you made a kid laugh and you're like, wait, that's going to affect the way I deliver a line on the show? Like, has it affected the way you act?
That's a great question. The kids are so silly. You know what, to sort of transition in answering that question, I'm surprised at what they laugh at. So I'll be watching the show with friends or family, and I'm shocked at what the joke that I'm like, that is not a good joke, that the 6-year-old, 7-year-old just falls on the floor. And so then it makes me not sort of judge it as much. I'm like, the kids are going to eat this one up. You know?
That's so smart. That's interesting.
It's what they laugh at. It really gets me. And I'm like, oh, that is funny. I mean, of course, the falling down and the punching and the easy stuff, but certain jokes they just get.
Right.
And I realize that this is its own medium. It's its own bag of tricks, you know.
So when your show airs, like, you know, it used to be when you were on TV, you're like, oh, I want a recorder, I want to get a copy. Now, do you DVR it?
Yeah, I DVR it, and I have a DVD recorder, and I record it from the DVR. It's amazing. I'm sure there's an easier way, but that's good for me for now. At least now I know sort of how to get it onto, you know, hard copy to show my mom or something. So.
Well, it was so great to meet you, and thank you so much.
You as well. Great last name.
Thank you. Have a great one.
Thank you.